Hi, Jack. So the first word that comes to mind when I think of Jack is unique. While this may seem cliche, Jack is truly one of the more unique individuals I've met in my time in education. The perspective he brings to a topic can always be counted to push your thinking and send the group in a new direction. I watched this firsthand when, at Hulbert, Jack was able to lead his group towards unusual and creative solutions to team-building problems. He's a natural leader in the problem-solving world, and people look to him for advice on heady topics. He created the most intricate Secret Santa puzzle this year for Beckett, right? It was pretty, you were blown away. And he loves problems with logical solutions. Jack has a unique sense of style. That's a nice time. He was one of only four boys to wear a full semi-formal this year. Or one of the only boys, sorry. And he sure knows how to boogie when he's on the dance floor, let's just say that. I don't think we want to demonstrate that, though, right now. All right. So, he has sported an inadvertent dreadlock for much of the year, and spent the first half of the year with perpetually untied shoes. And was that not a style thing? I'm not sure. Okay. Right. So, Jack also has unique food interests for a middle schooler. This kid eats more dairy in one day than some children consume in a week. He's known for having great wafers, for being the school chocolate milk supplier, and just the other day he asked if he could have a day off from school because it was National Brie Day. I can only assume that the Brie representatives sent him notice of this because he consumes so much of their product. Jack is also unique in his skills and interests. He loves team sports and is good at both soccer and ultimate frisbee, but he's also a passionate rock climber and a member of the Mavericks team. He placed first in the region and in the top 12 in the state with his math prowess, and he was the school geography champion and went on to be top 10 in the state in geography as well. Jack was also a member of the Quarter Century Club and is a consummate reader of high-end texts. He's developing his new interest in coding, and if you're ever lucky enough to listen to him play the piano, you'll know that he can go for Baroque. Jack's also a tremendous artist. He takes his time and is meticulous and planful in his art, and has beautiful results to show for his work. Jack was also a leader in the circus this year. He recited Pi, walked on stilts, and was one of our fastest fencers. He's quite the Renaissance man. Now, if we could just add consistently turning in homework, using time in a reasonable fashion. So some of those skill sets, I think we would see things heading in a really positive direction over the next 4 years in high school. Michael, note that, and with that I give you Jack Brandon.
After a long 2 years of middle school, I look forward to this summer with great enthusiasm, but also with sadness, for I am leaving the place I spent the last 2 years of my life. But that's what life is about, moving on. Now that high school looms in front of me, I must accept this change and go into it with an open mind. It has been fun, playing soccer games, watching Quinn have a fit of laughter during his religion presentation, discussing infinite cheese grenades with Elliot in math class, and overall just spending time with all the friends I've made. I hope I am remembered as a strange nerd, that guy with really disgusting hair that has way too many dairy products, because the unordinary is remembered the most. You know who said that? Probably no one. I have improved a lot. I actually had a science fair this year. And look, I wrote this whole speech in the car on the way here. I would also like to thank my teachers for filling my brain with knowledge. Marcy, thanks for teaching me to speak English good. Claire, thank you for teaching me all of the elements of the periodic table, like hygiene and your agency. Thank you, Fallon, for teaching me all the history stuff, like the American War. Something. Civil completion. Sandy, thank you so much. You volunteered to teach the three of us kids in your math class. And Andrew. Oh boy. You guys do not get paid enough. Middle school is a time of change, a transition, in which we learn to work hard and increase our understanding of the world we live in. It is the bridge between childhood and adulthood. I feel that my time at TSA Middle School was well spent, and I will be ready for my approach to high school. As for the future, well, as Mabel Pines once said, morality is a relative. I hope I don't die.